Before any of the tours really were established, George Abbott from the Marvelettes walked out on the stage. He said, "Now the Marvelettes." And she walked out on the stage with her eyes wide and chewing gum and looking at all the people and said, you know, just country style. And I said, "It's not going to work. We got to have a department that would groom the kids." And since most of them were ghetto kids that came from single homes, single parent homes, and didn't have all the cultural tactics that's needed, we decided to give it to them.
They asked me to open up the finishing school there. Motown Finishing School. Of course, the youngsters, you know, they came from humble beginning, and some were rude and crude from the street and the project. But with me, it isn't where you come from, it's where you're going.
She taught us how to be elegant, and that's what we wanted. It wasn't something, we weren't being taught something that we didn't want. We wanted to be better. We wanted to, you know, aspire to be the best. She'll say, "Now, ladies." Oh, golly. We used to hate her then.
She was the brunt of a lot of jokes, I'll say that, because as young girls, we didn't take her seriously. But I did, in my heart, and I applied everything she taught me. And I can't really do anything now without thinking of Mrs. Powell. If I sit, if I talk, if I walk, if I carry myself at all, Mrs. Powell is there.
Everything had to be done in a classy way. So if they were doing the shake or whatever, well, we didn't do it in a vulgar way. With Diana Ross and the Supremes, we worked on singing and expressing yourself, looking pleasant and with a smile and maybe a gesture and how to handle a mic, you see, so that the mic don't handle you. I don't want you ever to look forward, lean forward. You do not protrude the buttock.
In many cases, the artists just went out and they sang and danced and they jumped around. And they wasn't accustomed to having to be concerned about projection and physical drama. You had to add a lot of movement that would be attractive to the ladies. And the ladies had to do movements that would attract the men. Sometimes when I was working with the Supremes on that movement, Mary used to say to me, "You're trying to teach me how to look ladylike," which is exactly what I was doing, because I was giving them moves like very feminine moves where you use your shoulders, and wave your hands, and all this kind of business, and keep you so that the fellas are going to really notice what you're putting down.
We would go into artist development at Motown and work on a song, and it would take hours. And we put in hours every day learning those routines. People have often said that Motown kind of made us over and made us into these sophisticated little dolls, you know, but I think that's something that we brought within ourselves. And so Charlie was able to keep us the way we were, but still keep that sophistication and to keep it sexy and to keep the rock and roll, all that as one unit. Mm-hmm.